Beware of the corporate mind, written by a truth soldier. The corporate mind lives in a dream world of the corporate image and delusions. First, I would explain what the corporate image is. The image is not at all what the corporation is, but the corporation will not spare any efforts or resources to maintain their fake beautiful public corporate image. This corporate image is achieved through the use of corporate media such as advertisements, on television, radio and the press. This corporate image is what the corporate mind is built on. Any individual that has ever had any difficulties or injustices done to them by the corporation will have to first come to the realization that one has to see behind the corporate mask image before there will ever be any chance of justice. That will be a very hard deed to achieve indeed. For everyone that works for a corporation has been very carefully trained to have a corporate mind. The corporate mind hides behind this corporate image, and for the individual, that is the corporate mask. So that when the corporate mind looks at the mirror of life, they are looking through the narrow-minded vision of those little holes cut out of the mask for their eyeballs. Then when the corporate mind looks through the holes into the mirror of life, the corporate mind only sees the pretty fake corporate mask face looking back at them. But the corporate mind has become completely incapable of looking at the world without hiding behind the corporate mask. Because if they did, they would have to have a conscience. And then the corporate mind would have to look into that mirror of life and see just how evil and insane that corporate mask makes them be. Many very good people have sought and gained employment at a corporation, elevating the very beautiful and elaborate corporate image that has been presented to us. But very soon after their employment, they discover that the corporate image has very little to do with reality. This is when the corporate mind starts to develop. For the new employee will now do everything it can to fit in and keep their employment. So they can have the shiny car in front of their new four-bedroom house that they got a loan from a corporate bank to pay for it. So this once very sincere and honest person now has to abide by the conspiracy agreement they had to sign to get that corporate job. For those of you who refuse to accept that conspiracies exist, here is the facts. The conspiracy agreement is called the Secrecy Non-Disclosure Agreement. Unlike companies that operate openly in the society they exist in and openly contribute for the good of society and will respond openly to any injustices, the corporate secrecy agreement is essentially a crime syndicate agreement, where you agree to never disclose to anyone the workings and activities of the corporation. A corporation does not openly and honestly participate in and contribute to the democratic society they are operating in. They only seek to suck every profit they can. So if the corporation operates in a free and open society known as a democracy, the corporation is absolutely anti-democratic, for a democracy cannot function when there is any organization with the veil of secrecy present. Corporations only maintain an image of truth, for truth is not allowed to be spoken by any member of a corporation to anyone not a member of their crime syndicate. The corporation does not mind that society or an individual's rights may be being trampled on or destroyed. The employee with the corporate mind knows that no matter what evil the corporation does, it will always polish its corporate image no matter the cost. And I mean any cost, including crime and death. Truth and justice, which is what a free and open democratic society is based on, does not matter to the corporate mind, because the corporate image is everything to the corporate mind. The corporation will always put the most genuine and innocent people up front, such as the receptionist. These upfront cover people will know next to nothing about the evils of the corporations they work for until their experience grows, and then those that still have a conscience and it catches up to them, so they call in sick. Please read my article entitled "He Called In Sick," because these kind and sincere cover people are expendable. Anyone is expendable to a corporation. Remember that a corporate structure of business is nothing but an elaborate crime syndicate. That is why corporations are committing crimes against humanity, the individual, the environment and everything else unimaginable. Only a truth soldier will ever go beyond the corporate image to discover the true evils of the insane corporate mind. Seeking and speaking the truth of the evils in this world is a very dangerous thing to do. Please read my article, A Truth Soldier, to better understand. So most employees of a corporation, in particular those on the front lines that deal with the problems caused by the corporate crimes, walk around quite happy and content and have nothing but contempt for the rest of us. The corporate heads are usually very beautiful in appearance because they are not stressed. They wear the best clothes, eat the best foods. They live the most comfortable lives. And care not for you, the outsider. If they didn't care, they too would soon call in sick. These corporate minds are very dangerous indeed, for if you are able to break through their very shiny exterior, you will see the devil itself cowering inside the dark place. The devil is scared of the light of truth getting in. Our world and society today is in very great peril, for since the creation of the first corporation, natural evolution based on truth and sanity has disappeared and is hidden behind that very pretty corporate image. Please read my article, Creation of First Corporation, Worst Crime in Human History, to understand how society evolved from a free and the dream of a fair democracy to where today truth no longer matters, for only the illusion of truth and democracy matter. The word corporation never existed before this first corporation was created. The creators used the words corruption and corporation, then created corporation, translated as corruption, meaning to cooperate in crime. For, like I said before, all corporate structures are nothing but crime syndicates. Beware of the corporate mind, for they do not mind to speak no truth. Today our world is in very great peril indeed, for here in my country all governments are now registered corporations, pretending to be governments of the people, for the people and by the people. Instead they are corporations for corporations. Please read my The Last Democracy Is Dead article. If the future of this planet is not guided by truth, then we are all doomed. For truth is absolute and insanity is the absolute opposite. So beware of the corporate mind, for they care not that they be insane. For they are insane with the pleasures that their selfish corporate minds can achieve. The revolutionary army of truth soldiers needs you now. It is time for a truth revolution, for when the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the enlightenment. Telling the truth in times of universal deceit is a revolutionary act. I long for the old timers' dreams of truth, justice and liberty for all. We will never have it if you do not mind to do something about the evil flourishing on this planet because of the creation of the first corporation. We will never be free if you do not free yourself from the corporate illusions that you have been deliberately trapped in. Be careful how you try to free your mind, as if you use violence they will put you in one of their corporate prisons. The answer is for the sanity of truth to reach those poor corporate minds and bring them out of the dark and into the light of truth. God is the light of truth. In God we trust. Or it will be your end. Your end has been written in stone. Please read my article, They Want You Dead Is Written in Stone. Follow a truth soldier on www.twitter.com/danieltowsey, and you can read more of my articles at danieltowsey.wordpress.com. Free high-res images of God's creations at danieltowsey.photoshop.com. Beware of the corporate mind, written by a truth soldier.